Hey, here we are, and today I'm going to talk to you about the second set of three C's. Now, the first set, confidence, connection, and challenge. Those are the C's that I've talked about most often in the past when I'm in front of a parent group, parent education night, school brings me in. That is the presentation that I give, because no matter where you are along the educational spectrum, kindergarten, fifth grade, middle school, high school, you can connect those three themes to the challenges that kids are facing, the importance of confidence, yada, yada, yada. Now, today, the second group of three C's, choices, consequences, and consistency. I don't know, maybe more important than even the first three. So I'm going to start talking more and more about those. Let's go from back to front. Okay, consistency. Essentially, you're, as a parent, do what you say, say what you mean. Okay, do what you say what you mean. So if you've set down the rules, the expectations in your house, whether it's what kids are going to be doing on the weekend to help out around the home, whether it's your expectations for their academic performance in school, whether it's the expectation of where they can go, where they can't go with their friends on the weekend, do what you say what you mean, be consistent about it. Kids like to know where the boundaries are. They like to know what the rules are, and they don't like it when you change them all the time. Be consistent, okay? Be consistent. Now the second, consequences, really connects with the first, which is choices. Consequences, positive and negative, essentially give your kids the opportunity to experience consequences, both positive and negative, as a result of their choices. If you take that from them, you rob them of really some incredible life experience. So consequences, academically, they choose not to do their homework, there's a consequence, okay? Consequence, you don't fix your lunch in the morning, what is it? You're gonna be hungry, all right? You give kids the opportunity to really experience some of the consequences, they learn. Progressing along the road, they become more independent. They build up some of these skills that they're going to need in order to be able to survive as an independent adult. So give them the opportunity to really see what some of the consequences are of the choices. And then let's back up number one, choices. Okay? Short of your child going out and playing in the street, right, or any other choice that puts them in the way of physical harm, you know, give them opportunities, folks, to make choices. All right? Choices. And really think long term. Hey, if the choice they make today about the color of the bathroom, the one that they use that's in their bedroom every day that you don't even go into, and they want to paint it a different color, you know, is that going to matter a year from now? Really? All right? So think about some of the choices that you're making or you're not allowing your kids to make, and really back up and say, you know what? Number one, is this going to put them in physical harm? No. Passes that test. Number two, a year from now, is this choice really going to matter? No. All right. Give them an opportunity. Let them make those choices. Okay, the secondary effect there is when kids make choices, they feel like they're getting real input. They feel like they're having a real effect on what's happening around them. Kids during the middle school years, they like to know that they make a difference. So give them the opportunity to make some real choices in their life. All right, Wednesday show coming back tomorrow, pre-big show, which will be Thursday. Getting ready for the wrap-up of another week. You take care of yourself.